Now, another news, falling metal prices and rising imports are further eroding the already battered metal space. Speaking on the sidelines of the India Copper Forum, Balwinder Kumar, Mines Secretary, saying the government is working towards safeguarding the industry better. Hear him out.
Aluminium as well as copper, number one, primary metal prices have fallen sharply, LME prices. And second, that because of that, imports have also risen. So for increased imports and LME price, so the profitability has affected badly in the primary metal manufacturers. So that is why they are demanding for protection of duty. So in case of aluminium, they have already moved a proposal for safeguard duty of 10%, and safeguard commissioner is handling this issue. And I have also suggested to Copper Association, this Copper Indian Copper Forum, that they should also build up a case and move for safeguard duty, because that can help them directly. If that is not materialized, then certainly government can think later on for duty protection.
And they've also raised a number of concerns with regards to FTA, with regards to imports also. So going forward, what is the government looking to do to address these concerns of the copper industry?
Joint Secretary Commerce was also here, and he has noted down this problem of FTA. And they will be addressing this issue shortly. Regarding bauxite, there are some mines which would be put on auction. I know that in Jharkhand there is one mine, and also in Madhya Pradesh. So basically, and Gujarat also, there is a scope for bauxite. That is why Gujarat Mining Corporation has also moved a proposal to set up a joint venture with NALCO. So hopefully this bauxite as well as copper ore, three mines are put on auction, two PL cum ML and one for ML.
While metal makers remain hopeful on a demand pickup, they add that there are no major capex plans in store.
I think the copper demand in India has been growing quite well over the last year, and I see the demand to be picking up, because a lot of projects have been announced, and a lot of power projects have been cleared. I think housing should also pick up now that the interest rates are down. Automobile sector is doing well, so I think the overall demand for copper should be very, very good over the next year.
What we are focusing as of now is to improve the efficiencies of the operations to the world level. That is our focus. Second, wherever possible, to reduce the cost, because it is a tough time for the industry. And as far as capex is concerned, we don't have any big plans. However, we are investing in the value-added products. I am very bullish. The government has taken certain initiatives to boost the economy. So the industry, manufacturing, infrastructure, telecommunication, this should increase the demand of copper, and that is how we are hopeful that the demand should be better than the GDP growth.
Alright, take a break. On the other side, we'll get your FNO segment, and I guess today Bhavan Desai, Motilal Oswal. Just stay tuned for that.